So let us start again with Kalsarp Yoga. What did we see in the previous video? We understood what Kalsarp Yoga was. We also understood what was the importance of snakes in the Indian mythology and Puranic stories. We also checked out what Kalsarp Yoga consists of. That is, how do planets form or how are they arranged when we have Kalsarp Yoga? So keeping all these things in mind, let us move ahead and check out what Kalsarp Yoga constitutes now. Moving ahead, we see that there are certain parameters when Kalsarp Yoga is more effective. We know that Rahu is the face of the body and Rahu-Ketu. So now here we see that in this instance, we see that Rahu, which is always moving in an anti-clockwise direction, is facing the planets. It is moving towards the planets. As it moves in its transit, it will have a very strong effect on the planets here. And as we move down, we see that in such a case, Rahu has already passed all the planets, and for the half a cycle, it is not going to affect the planets. On the contrary, Rahu is going to have an effect on this chart only during the other half, that is during the transit. So this chart is not as effective as the chart shown earlier. This chart, in case of formations of planets by this chart or as per this chart, is not that effective in terms of Kalsarp Yoga as is the other chart. But before we move ahead and explain the types of Kalsarp Yoga, let me put up some important points that should be considered while doing Kalsarp Yoga. Now, when we are analyzing a chart for Kalsarp Yoga, it is very important to consider certain factors. Otherwise, the person whom we are analyzing the chart for might just be rendered weak. Weak in the sense, weak in the heart. You know, the person might feel afraid that he has a certain dreadful yoga, so as to say, in his chart. It may not be the case. He may not have the yoga, and this yoga, as we will see further, has the propensity to give us a Raj yoga also. We need to first note as to which houses do we cover in case there is a Kalsarp Yoga present in the person's chart. We need to see which houses are covered during this yoga. Also, we need to see what are the positions of these two houses. What are the positions of the lords of these two houses? There may be certain planets which may be very powerfully placed than Rahu and Ketu, thus causing a yoga bhang. Or these planets can also cause a fact that the Rahu and Ketu can have lesser impact as compared to the other charts. Okay, due to different longitudes of the planets, and very minorly so, we can have certain planets which will cause yoga bhang, and this I have shown ahead in case of an example. So it's very important to establish Kalsarp Yoga in a chart. Here in this chart, we see that Rahu and Ketu are covering all the planets in between them. And it is a very strong yoga also, because Rahu is facing all the planets. So when it moves in its progression also, not just transit, it is going to move over each planet before it comes as a transit. But does Kalsarp Yoga exist in this chart? No. Let's have a good look as to why. Let's see the degree of Ketu, which is with a retrograde Mars. Ketu is at 12 degrees and Mars is at 4 degrees. It means Mars is beyond the orbit of Ketu. What would that mean? That means not all the planets are within the Rahu-Ketu axis. Thereby, there is a yoga bhang. So next time you check a chart out for Kalsarp Yoga, make doubly sure that all the planets are within the orbit of Rahu and Ketu. And in cases like these, also check out if a planet is beyond the orbit or within the orbit. As we move ahead, we see that there are certain things that Kalsarp Yoga does bestow to us. Kalsarp Yoga does give us Raj Yoga at many a times. Now this Kalsarp Yoga can be very much compared to a churning of the ocean. When we are churning the ocean, there is a lot of halahal, as you have read in the stories of mythology, that there was a lot of halahal which was produced. What was halahal? Halahal was the very, very strong poison that was so very effective that even its fumes caused the devatas and the danavs to fall asleep, to die, to have problems. Now, if there's something that can cause so much of issues, so much of problems to the devatas and the danavs, do you think that it would not affect the humans? It definitely does affect the humans. So when you have a Kalsarp Yoga like combination in your chart, you do have to skim over a lot of halahal in your life. That is, you will have to face circumstances which would be no less than a poison for you. However, once you withstand it, once you have somebody to your aid to help you out, as Lord Shiva came to the aid of the devtas and the danavs alike, he took in the halahal and he poured it down his throat, contained it in his throat, and then everything was back to normal. And the churning continued. And after the churning came out all the best things possible, the Kamdhenu cow, which gave all the riches to the rishis so that they could perform their yagnas so very beautifully. There came Surabhi, there came Uchishrava, the horse, which is the celestial horse, which is a gift to Lord Indra. They came Kostubmani, which was given to Lord Vishnu, and he wears this on his chest. And then we have Lord Lakshmi, Goddess Lakshmi, coming out of it. So there's so many things that come out of this Kalsarp Yoga, this churning of the ocean. Kalsarp Yoga does give us the Raj Yoga. But for that, you have to withstand the halahal. One thing we need to be very sure of, that there is a good coming out of so much poison that comes into our lives. We just need to learn to contain that poison and not go berserk when this poison enters in any life. It can make a person very famous, give wealth, luxury, and also fame. Planets which give good results help in mitigating this yoga. If there is an exalted Saturn, if there is an exalted Jupiter, these planets being very strong by the virtue of their position. But don't take it vertebrum, because it has to be seen as to which house lords they are, what is the lagna, etc. But the planets, if they are essentially very strong, they have the ability to get down this Kalsarp Yoga to a lot of extent. Now, there are 12 zodiac signs. And with respect to the 12 zodiac signs, we get 12 lagnas. With the respect of these 12 lagnas, you have 288, no less than 288 types of Kalsarp Yoga which can be formed. Prominently, however, here we are going to discuss only 12 types of Kalsarp Yoga, depending on the houses they occupy in the chart. So, before we move on to the different kinds of Kalsarp Yoga, let us check out what are the prominent features of the Kalsarp Yoga. We can see snakes in their dreams. The people who have Kalsarp Yoga have the ability to see snakes in their dreams. There are times that they may struggle very hard and yet get no success. This is an important point to remember. And whenever you're facing such a problem, remember that there was a huge amount of struggle involved in the first phase of churning of the ocean. A mighty resolve was needed on account of both the devtas and the danavs to struggle and to churn the ocean, but at the end of it, they were successful. Also, the initial churning was just the poison. So initially, even though you faced a lot of problems, you worked hard, you may not get all that you want. On the contrary, you may get something very, very undesirable, but just know that it is just the darkest hour before the dawn. There is something good coming up. So get your bearings together. All the tension that you are undergoing, all the mental trauma that you are undergoing will be rewarded very soon. So do not let go of that struggle. Do not give up, because you have to know that there is at round the corner a pot of gold waiting for you. Person may make enmities with others for no reason. This is the snake nature calling. So you might just end up making enmities for no reason. You might make up enmities because you are under so much of pressure that you do not know what to do. So everyone appears to look as an enemy to you. Be aware, don't worry, it will work out for you. Hidden enemies can create problems for the person, and many nature problems can happen. But as I said, and have been saying and been repeating, don't worry, it will work itself out. Unrest and turbulence in the life of a person. Know that all of us here are there to cut, to pay certain debts. So take it in stride and work towards the best. There are many people who have Kalsarp Yoga, and after an initial period of struggle, have achieved untold heights. Delay in marriage or situations of separated in marriage life. This is one factor, and it is very, very common to Anant Kalsarp Yoga because it happens from 1 to 7 houses. Now, when the Rahu is in Lagna and Ketu is in the 7th house, the formation of the Kalsarp Yoga so formed is called Anant Kalsarp Yoga. When Rahu is in the 2nd house and Ketu in the 8th house, we have Kulik Kalsarp Yoga being formed. When Rahu is in the 3rd house and we have Ketu in the 9th house, we have Vasuki Kalsarp Yoga formed. And when Rahu is in the 4th house and Ketu in the 10th, the Kalsarp Yoga so formed is called the Sankalp Kalsarp Yoga. 5th to 11th yoga is called the Padma Kalsarp Yoga, and 6th to 12th is the Mahapadma Kalsarp Yoga. As we move ahead, we see what happens when Anant Kalsarp Yoga is formed. The formation from the Lagna to the 7th house is called Anant Kalsarp Yoga. It gives mental tensions, imbalances in life, cunningness, loss of fame, stress, and unhappy married life. Yes, so it does happen that way. Not only that, but you will see that people who have their Rahu and Ketu placed in the houses 1 to 7, irrespective whether it's a Kalsarp Yoga or no, do show certain traits, diluted no matter. However, these traits are very much present for the people who have Rahu and Ketu in 1 bar 7 axis. Whenever Rahu is present in the first house, it boosts up the self. It makes a person more self-oriented, and Ketu sitting in the 7th house totally covers the 7th house. That is, it makes the renders the person not paying attention to the 7th house. Now, the 7th house is not just the self. It is also the secondary house of profession. So, that house also gets accompanied. It also gets a lot of affected, and married life is affected. In this Kalsarp Yoga, we see that being the 7th house, Ketu will have a problem with work. It will have show problem with married life. Kulik Kalsarp Yoga. Formation of the Rahu and Ketu Kalsarp Yoga between the 2nd houses and the 7th houses. Now, formation from the 2nd house to the 7th to the 8th house, it affects the health of the native, because 8th house is again the health. The 2nd house is about your ability to accrue your money. The 2nd house is also your family, so there can be defamation in the family. 2nd house is morals. 2nd house is also your khyati, or it is also your administrativeness. It is also the earned reputation that you have. And all these things get affected by the affliction of due to Kalsarp Yoga and placement of Rahu and Ketu between the 2nd and the 8th, along with all the planets. So here we stop again, making another video for the next time with the rest of the houses. Stay tuned, stay in the same place. Till then, bye.